ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बेस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड योर एंटायर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद गीता वर्स नंबर 45 ऑफ 11th चैप्टर। अर्जुन उवाच अदृष्टपूर्वं हृषितोऽस्मि दृष्ट्वा भयेन च प्रव्यथितं मनो मे तदेव मे दर्शय देवरूपं प्रसीद देवेश जगन्निवास। एज अर्जुन एक्सपीरियंस्ड विश्वरूप, नाउ बीइंग अ ह्यूमन बीइंग अर्जुन हैज आल्सो अ टाइनी लिमिटेड माइंड। द माइंड ऑलवेज गोज टू द कंफर्ट जोन, इट वोंट आर इट never let us to be in insecure or in vast manner or vast aspects. The same way here, he is very happy that he could have darshan of Lord Vishwarupa. But at the same time, one corner of his mind is terrified by seeing the mouth of the God. So when he saw the mouth of the God, so all people near, dear, and even enemies, they were entering into the mouth ruthlessly and in cruel manner. Everybody were crushed by Bhagwan's teeth, and so many people, they were crying, shouting, and craving for savage from the death. But Bhagwan, being uncompassionate, he was just swallowing them, and he was crushing them like anything. That terrifying mouth, the nature of the mind always goes to that which is endowed with tragedy. Now Arjuna's mind, being very limited like in a human mind, it cannot come out of the emotions. And it won't also allow us to forget the tragedy which happened in our life. It gives a lots of changes, transformation after a small tragedy which happens in our life. In the same way, when he saw the mouth of Bhagavan, his mind was terrified, tortured, means tormented by that. Therefore, now he automatically he wishes to have the previous form, which was Saumya form, which was like a human being. Even may he be a Vishwarupa Ishwara, but his mind would like to have interaction with Krishna, who was near, dear. That's what, the normal human being, if anybody who studied with us and who enjoyed with us in our childhood, he has become a prime minister or president or some, position in which, he is endowed with throughout the nation, throughout the world. But you wish to have him to continue as your own friend. So you always wish him to come at your home as like before. The same thing is happening with Arjuna too. He says, अदृष्टपूर्वं दृष्ट्वा हृषितः अहमस्मि। me. So I'm very happy, O Lord, by seeing the very rare, that which is very difficult to see, to have darshan by other people. Even for me also, I have never seen such kind of vast experience. But you know, bhayena pravethitam manome, my mind is terrified by seeing one side of you, my Lord. My mind is not able to tolerate it. My mind doesn't have the capacity to digest it. That one factor which is not able to be digested by whole human being, the death factor, the factor of disasters, we won't. That's what human mind is. Always we are keen and attracted with these tragedies. Our mind goes. Therefore, people always would like to see the movie which is endowed with horror kind of things, tragedy kind of things, and the movie which talks about terrorism, the movie which talks about which shows all kinds of disaster. People are very keen to see, but they don't like. They don't like, but they are attracted by the disaster, because that's what the human mind is. So where it goes and locked, wherever it feels insecure, it always thinks about it. So when I experienced yourself as the Bhayankaratvam, as the tragedy, as the cruel aspects of the life, but that too you are, but still my mind is not endowed with that kind of preparation. Therefore, sadhana chatushtayam is required for a student. When we begin the Vedanta, because Bhagavan has started in the battlefield itself. Otherwise, Vedanta is not easily started or began by a guru. The guru will check about your sadhana chatushtaya. So, viveka, vairagya, shama, dama, etc. Six kinds of qualifications. And mumukshutvam. The mumukshu should be jignyasu. So, all these categories have to be there with the students. Then alone Vedanta will begin. Otherwise, no Vedanta lesson will begin. So at least, you know, so after Chinmayananda, Swami Chinmayananda, he just gave the world. Before Swami Chinmayananda, Vedanta was not given as now it is being provided by the Acharyas. Because they go for the qualification, Adhikarithva Visheshaha. That Adhikarithva means that one should have the prepared mind. That preparation, so like the preparing the land for the cultivation. So in agriculture department, if wherever you go and see the land which is prepared for the cultivations, it takes long time. It is being filled with water, and they allow the water to be there at least for 3 days, and everything, when it gets moistured, they flow with drill, power tiller or tractor, and they make, you know, they prepare the land so nice that they can just, you know, put the saplings. And nursery garden, they prepare paddy or whatever they prepare in separate place, they bring and they put it on the land. Then, otherwise they sow the seeds. Before that, there are lots of process must be done. In the same way, Vedanta is a kind of proper agriculture kind of operation. It needs the mind which is equalized with land, has to be prepared well. That is required. But you know, in the battlefield, no time was available. Therefore, Bhagavan had begun. Because of the lacking of sadhana chatushtaya, Arjuna facing the problem, he is not able to tolerate, his mind is not able to accept the factor, that the important factor of the life. Now he is requesting, Tadeva me darshiya deva rupam prasida devesha diganivasa. Tadeva me darshiya, he deva. Tadeva rupam darshaya me. So please show me the form which you had before. So that form, he has not informed what kind of form. Please bless me, proceed, be gracious to me हे देवेश, ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ लॉर्ड्स और गॉड ऑफ गॉड्स, जगन निवास हु इज अबोड ऑफ द जगत. सो दिस वर्ड्स ही हैज रिक्वेस्टेड, सो प्लीज प्रोवाइड मी दैट फॉर्म. विच फॉर्म? इट इज एक्सप्लेन इन द नेक्स्ट वर्ड्स. लेट अस रीड इट. किरीटिनम गदिनम चक्रहस्तम इच्छामि त्वाम द्रष्टुमहं तथैव तेनैव रूपेण चतुर्भुजेन सहस्रबाहो भव विश्वमूर्ते. And few acharyas also give the reason. Because this Divya Drishti which has been provided to Arjuna was temporary, artificial one. He was not enough to develop. So he was not given enough practice to develop. Therefore, this Patanjali Yoga Sutra also, they help you to prepare. Your mind has to be subtilized. So subtilized, I don't know whether the word is or not. You have to make your mind to the level from where you can digest the subtlest thing of the understanding of the Ishwar. That artificial means it is temporary, it's provided by somebody else. So when you are given vision, so it is like, you know, when you go directly to study Vishwarupa Ishwara Darshanam, you won't get anything at all. You might have been prepared from 7th chapter. The 7th chapter, it begins to teach about Lord's Swarupa, God's Swarupa. But before that, you would have been, or you might have been understood or informed about yourself. The self-realization helps you to get into God realization. If you have not realized about yourself, mere God realizations will bring more complications with you. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita begins with the self-realization. The realization of the self involves or includes the realization of the God. That's what Aham Brahmasmi means. Only it's not referring you are nothing but that. I am Brahman. So I am the God. Then you should know who is God. Before saying I am the God, you should have been understood. Isn't it? You should have been understood means it's, I'm making it purposely passive. Because the Brahman is everything. It understands you. You should be absorbed by the knowledge of Brahman. It means you should have been lost your individuality in that understanding known as Paramarthika level of understanding. As though this is Vyavaharika level of understanding, understanding God as the creator, now understanding with the Anekarupa Ishwara. See, the Ekarupa Ishwara, you always, you love to have your comfort zone. When you are provided a bus to travel anywhere, you won't like it. So you like a big car, bus and all, but you know, mind likes to have a small car, that the car with compact, so the car which suits you, so you can just go with freedom. So when you have the huge car and many people sit, you lose your privacy. That is what is happening with him. So therefore, we have to understand the mind of Arjuna. Though he was pleased by, he was very happy. So like, you know, my guru gives one example. So he gives, you know, in Kerala, there is any function, you know. So the many elephants are invited. Any festival, the role of elephant is very important. And everybody keen to go on the elephant. Because on the elephant, the god is being taken to the river, to temple. Everybody wish to be with gods on the elephant. And whoever sitting on the elephant, all other people envies on him. Once, you know, the Swamiji also provided a chance to sit over there. Not when he was young. You know, after sitting on elephant, there was no cushions. And, you know, only cinema, it is shown with cushions and like some kind of asans over there. So nothing was provided, nothing was spreaded like a velvet cushion and all. So when he sat, the bone was so hard. That bone was very strong and harder than the diamond. So, and you know, the hair on the elephant skin, it was like a needle. It's not the hair like on human being. It was, you know, pinching like anything. He was not able to sit properly. Just he was, you know, having that discomfort. But people are envious from down, and all people were wishing. So, and cheering him up. So he kept himself quiet. After him coming down, he didn't reveal to others, because you know all other people will be they were envy on him. We enjoy that, you know, we enjoy it like that. Arjuna's mind. So who could have Vishwarupa Darshana? If anybody hears that, oh my God, how fortunate you are, how lucky you are. So you are the luckiest person in the world. But he alone will understand the dangerous form of God, that which terrifies him. Therefore, he wants to compromise his own mind. He wants to see again the Lord with a Saumya Darshana, that comfortable form, which was in the form of a friend of Arjuna. That is the form which is explained, Kiritinam, the one which with crown, as a king of Dwaraka, Gadinam, who has the mace, Gadayuda, and who is having Sudarshana Chakra, means a disc which is called Sudarshana Chakra in his hand. Aham Tvam Drashtum Tathaiva Ichhami, I would like to see in that form alone, as a normal person, as I could interact with you like I did before. Tenaiva Rupena Chaturbhujena, and with four hands. Now you are appearing with thousands of crores of hands. My mind is not able to expand that much. Sahasrabahu Bhava Vishwamurthe, please be gracious with me. Please bless with me. Now Bhagavan begins. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Maya Prasannena Tava Arjunedam Rupam Param Darshitam Atma Yogat Tejomayam Vishwamanantamadhyam Yenme Twadanyena Nadrashta Purvam. Now this conversation comes to an end. You think about the conversation between two childhood friends when they were young, and when they grow to be an adult people, at that time communications, it happens in different form. And after marriage, when they meet, the communication, the range of communication, the level of communication and the content of communication, entirely it is different. But have ever thought about communicating with the Almighty? All Upanishads, these Upanishads and even the Shastras, you might have seen, there are dialogues, there are conversation between the normal personality, the personality which is highly informed, or which is Almighty Himself. The conversation between man and God, the conversation between man and Guru, this conversation, now it is being completed with God and man. Now, the God alone being with Vishwarupa Darshana, the Bhagavan speaks, Maya Prasannena Yetam Rupam Darshitam, Idam Rupam Paramam Idam Rupam Atma Yoga Darshitam. The form which you are just experiencing now, it's being provided by me with pleasantly by me with my power of Maya. That's what you know. Atma Maya means that I am owning the power of Maya. Tejo Mayam Vishwam Anantam Adhyam Enme Twadanyena Nadrashta Purvam. So nobody had seen than you. You are the first one from the beginning of the Srishti, and the form which is all pervaded and Tejo Mayam, which is delightful and in self-effulgent. Vishwam Anantam Adhyam, that which is limitless, and that which is the beginning, the place of originate, place of entire creation. Then Bhagavan just letting him know, nobody has seen before than you. It seems to be Arjuna is very fortunate enough. Then also, you know, after Mahabharata, history continues. Arjuna, he was trying to recollect what and all was taught by Krishna. Okay. So in this verse, Maya prasannena tava Arjuna, not only to Arjuna, they bring their attitude, they are able to generate the attitude which Arjuna had, he will appear. That's what is happening in all the places, especially even in Tirumala, it is happening. You go with a proper attitude in front of Venkateshwara, it may be not felt in the first time itself. So when you are having sankalpa, so I would go to Tirumala and to have darshana of Lord Venkateshwara. So you need not to program before your program, before you are planning, the Venkateshwara will enter in you. That's what the glory. So Venkateshwara or any god, if you plan to go to them, if you want to go to the Kailash or Mount Kailash, or if you want to go to Badrinath, Kedarnath, or any temple, you know, which you love, when you plan or before you are planning, the God will come and enter into you. Like Venkateshwara, because I have been experiencing in my life. And go always, you know, not always, at least one time in your life, go through the steps. A beautiful experience. That experience, you know, that which, you know, if you fly or if you go by car, if you go by, so any vehicle, that's okay, fine, you know. So you can save your time, you can save your energy, and you can spend more time in Tirumala. But you know, when you go by the steps, that is different at all. This marvelous experience, no words to explain it. So whatever the vocabulary is I use, it may not enough to describe the happiness. You can take proper rest and you can reach Venkateshwara. You see the Venkateshwara after coming on the footpath, you go and see, you will have a different Venkateshwara. The Venkateshwara will give different kind of darshanam at that time. Prasannena, not for only Arjuna. We need not to think, you know, Arjuna was so fortunate enough to be as a friend of Krishna, therefore we should also be with a proper recommendation. No recommendations are needed, just, you know, Venkateshwara. So big administration is on in Tirumala because, you know, they would like to give proper time and what is the darshanam of Venkateshwara alone. That administration is nothing but Venkateshwara. So everybody who worked there, who, you know, participating in that administration, the grace of Venkateshwara alone is going on. Therefore, you need not to think that is very difficult. No, it's not at all difficult. Just you go by, and you know, every time they bring different, you know, program and facilities. I wonder sometimes, you know, how they can think this much. It's nothing but the glory of Venkateshwara. So that the human mind, so every human mind which is administrating there, it's a grace of Venkateshwara. That is Venkateshwara alone, that you can see the Vishwarupa. That Vishwarupa darshanam, you can see when you begin with, you know, when the footpath or any, you know, that the route in which the vehicle goes, you can see that from the beginning itself, from the arch itself, you can see the grace of Venkateshwara. That's a different experience, you know. So I need not to say this, but I would like to share my experience with the seven mountains called Yedukundalavad. So marvelous. Then he also refers, so you have got this opportunity, it's very rare, even the scholars, even the sadhakas. Sadhakas means the people who practice spiritualism. They are very rare to get this kind of darshanam. The importance of Vishwarupa darshanam is narrated by the God himself. Na veda yajna adhyayana irna danaihe na chakriya bhirna tapo bhirugraihe. Evam rupam shakya aham nirloke द्रष्टुं त्वदन्येन कुरु प्रवीर न वेद यज्ञाध्ययनैः. Not buying, practicing Vedas and learning Vedas, Vedic mantras. So any mantras, when you learn Vedas, the Veda mantras are himself, they are potential form of Ishvara. So Veda mantras are known as Shabda Brahman. But even Bhagavan says, even practicing Veda mantras with the meanings or mere recitation is not good enough to have this kind of Ishvarupa Darshanam. It requires a proper attitude with surrendering. That's what had happened with Arjuna. Therefore, he could have this darshan. If we also have that bhavana, means proper attitude towards any Ishvara, means the form of God, your Ishta Devata, you will definitely receive. That's a great thing in one's life, especially in the human life. We would also try. So Venkateshwara may bless for us to have a proper Ishvara Darshanam in our life. Let us continue this realm of journey from next class. Harihi Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namo Namaha. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.